Welcome to Space Engineers on the Xbox, on my Series X. This is an impromptu tutorial because I've been seeing a bunch of people asking questions on the Facebook group and all over the place about Mod Io. Xbox users and Mod Io. Mod Io used to be only for ships, stations, whatever you build, saved games, and so on. But now mods are on Mod Io. But we're not talking about mods because we talked about mods last time. This isn't a mod video. This is a Mod Io video, even though it has the word Mod Io in it. What is Mod Io? Well, when you boot up Space Engineers, it will ask you to basically accept an agreement between you and Mod Io. The rules for that agreement are on Mod Io and can be read as well as you accept the agreement. There is also the workshop agreement in the main menu under game. I've talked about this in my video on mods. Mod Io is the way that we get blueprints into games that we like. We see a ship, we bring that blueprint into the game. Now I want to stop and I want to say this, and this is important. Mod Io is there for your blueprints to go onto Mod Io. It is not there for you to take other people's ships without their permission, blueprint them and put them up on Mod Io, even if you want to play with those ships in the beta. If you're going to do that, set those ships to private, because if those ships appear public, you are essentially posting them as your work. Now, we've had to deal with this in the community previously. I was up for most of the night dealing with a particular person who may have done this. Now, all you've got to do is just blueprint your ships. Put your ships up on Mod Io. If you want to put somebody else's ship up on Mod Io or make a change to it, contact them. If you play with them, ask them directly. Do not plead ignorance and say, oh, but I didn't know, because the rules are there as you accept the agreement. They're on Mod Io's site and they're also on Keen Software's site. I will actually leave a link in the description to these rules. That said, let's get back to it, because I hate being the guy who says things like that. Mod Io. How do you get to it? Well, when you're playing the game, you hold down the right bumper and you press B. You will open the blueprint menu. But you will also see open item on Mod Io and browse. If you go to browse, you will open on your Xbox directly a bunch of mods. Now I can see straight away there's Chomper Mars Rover. That looks really cool. I'm intrigued with that. So what do we do? Well, we select it and we press A. That is now a blueprint that I'm subscribed to. We come back with B and press Y, you'll reload the blueprint list, refresh it, and somewhere down this list will be the Chomper. Now, if you're playing in creative, you will see, there it is, you will see that you can't paste this in. You can paste this in even. And there it is. I'm not playing in creative, I'm in survival, but I have creative mode tools active. And that is the only way that you can get a blueprint in like this. If you want to try and get a blueprint in to survival, then you need to build a blueprint projector and a welding room, or spend a long time welding that whole thing like this up. And it is tricky. And it can lag your Xbox, depending on the version you've got. But that is how you bring someone else's blueprint into your game, especially if you're playing creative or you have creative mode tools on. If you don't know how to enable it, hold down the right bumper press Y, and just swap the radio button to enable creative mode tools. There it is. But, I hear you ask, what about your own creations, your own ships? Well, I don't actually have anything, because this is a new save and I'm just structuring my base at the moment, that I can blueprint. So I'm going to bring in, using the blueprint menu, one of my ships. And I'm going to bring in something that's... Let's have a look. A simple little scout flyer. It's not really a ship, but it's worth me doing. This has a couple of mods on it, but it shouldn't be a problem. It will warn you. I think it's got all its thrusters. And it should be hovering, because there's another thing about blueprinting ships. I'm going to talk about blueprinting ships now. In that, when you blueprint a ship like this, what you need to do is make sure you have all your thrusters on, because if somebody else brings that ship in, it's going to come crashing down to the ground if they put it up too high. Okay, so this is the scout flyer. It's just a dead simple thing for scooting around planets on, and what we want to do is get this blueprinted. Now, if you look at it and you click in your right stick, you will see you open the right stick radial. Tap the right trigger once, you'll go to blueprint actions. Now, you have in creative mode four. You have create blueprint, copy grid, cut grid, and paste grid. So you want to create your blueprint. Now, what will happen is, if you've already got this in, it will create a second blueprint in this list and add a number to it. That's fine. Perfect for our little demo. So now we have the Scout Flyer 2. Scout Flyer 2 is not on Mod Io. I'm not going to put it on Mod Io, but I'm going to show you how to do it. So, make sure you've got a nice screenshot. That's one of the best things about Mod Io. So you want to catch a screenshot, say like this one, hold down the left bumper and tap right. You will remove your HUD. You can get some nice screenshots that way. Then all you need to do again is bring up your blueprint menu. Make sure you're on Scout Flyer 2. Use the left stick to get to take screenshot and tap it once. You'll see there's a screenshot. Then move across and hit publish. Do you want to publish this blueprint? Yes. Now all you need to do is select ship. We automatically upload to Mod Io. And press X. I'm not going to do so, but that will then upload your blueprint to Mod Io. Now, as long as you make changes to this, so for instance, say I paint this a whole different colour. Let's get my HUD back. Let's hold down the right bumper, tap down on the D-pad, press Y to default the palette, and let's have a look. We're going to change the colour on this thing to, let's see, I like the science fiction style circuit board effects, but I still like my red, so I'm going to hold down both bumpers and press Y, and there we go, lit up like a Christmas tree. Now, again, all we need to do with this is hit the right stick. Now, what you really want to do is copy the grid. And you copy it like this, and then you hold down left bumper, tap B. Come back to your Mod Io, your blueprint menu even. hold down left stick till you've got to your Scout Flyer 2 and tap replace. Do you want to replace this blueprint with the clipboard? Yes. Now hopefully when we do this, as you can see, if I bring this block closer, further away, closer, you'll see it is indeed the version that we just made. Now if you want to publish this as an update to an already published blueprint on Mod Io, all you need to do is go back to your blueprint menu, go to your Scout Flyer, make sure it has the same name as the blueprint you've already put up there. So if it is just called Scout Flyer, edit it, rename, take the two off, hit publish, go through the same deal, and you will publish the updated blueprint to Mod Io without needing to publish a second version of the ship. Mod Io will now update and put a second file as the main release of your vessel or station or vehicle onto Mod Io. I did the same with the Century Eagle, and I'll show you the Century Eagle. You can download this modded version of Mod Io. This is the ship I made last year when I first started playing the Xbox version of this. Again, this has got some mods in. The old version of the Century Eagle is vanilla, but you'll see I have made sure that the Eagle has all its thrusters on. And if I make changes to this, I can get this and take it to the beta using Mod Io. All I need to do is open up my blueprint menu, and everything is good. So let's cut this. And that's the blueprint menu and Mod Io in a nutshell. The VOD on this will be up on my Twitch channel for a while, but this will go up on YouTube once I stop recording it. As always, I tend to use Twitch as a way to record these things. I will start thinking about potentially streaming just some chill Space Engineers on. I may even stream my construction of this particular ice base over time. I don't claim to be one of the greatest Space Engineers players, far from it. I'm just having fun with the game, enjoying myself, trying out little builds here and there, learning tips and tricks, passing them on, and entertaining people, hopefully. What we've got here, though, is another neat little trick so you can get your own ships onto Mod Io. So again, blueprint menu and Browse Workshop. If you want to see the blueprints on your Xbox, if you tap the two squares, you'll be taken to Edge, and it will open the full blueprint menu on your Xbox, and you can use Edge to subscribe to blueprints as well. One more thing. You can see icons on the lower right of these pictures. That's the cloud. That's where your blueprints are stored. But as we go down, you'll notice that I've got a lot, because of course I've been playing this for a bit. There's the Chomper Mars rover. You'll see it has a cog. That's Mod Io. So any blueprint pulled from there is a Mod Io blueprint. Like I said, some of mine are on there. That particular ship there is a friend of mine's. That one is too. There's one of mine. There's the Century Eagle on Mod Io. And you can see I have a few bits and pieces from Mod Io. And there's the modded V1 Century Eagle on Mod Io. That's it. That's Mod Io in a nutshell. everything that hopefully you need tonight. Of how to look for blueprints, how to get them into the game. Remember, in survival, you've got to build a projector. Or creative mode tools and paste it in. Or, with the projector, you'll be welding for a while, especially on a large-scale ship. So you need to make a welding room, and those can be very, very PCU, or rather, system intensive. So, just have a think about that. If you're playing creative though, you've got no problems. You can paste in blueprints to your heart's content. Just remember, one thing about projectors is that they will only project the normal grid. They won't project a subgrid. So if you've got anything attached to the ship, like a little docking pod or some part of the ship that isn't part of the main grid, then that will not print using a projector. Okay, so over the weekend I will be doing my laser antenna tutorial. Look out for that one. Have fun, stay safe, take care, enjoy the game, and I will see you very shortly in the next one.